think the Sam's Club one probably.
I can't, man. I just made it up. I can't.
Good evening, and welcome to the Candlelight Processional. Tonight's presentation is under the baton of conductor Dr. John B. Sinclair. Dr. Sinclair is the conductor and artistic director of the Box Festival Society of Winter Park. He is also the chair and John M. Tietke Professor of Music at Rollins College.
Thank you.
of Liberty.
Gentlemen, let nothing you despise. What's cracking? Yes, my name is Neil. I am so honored to be your narrator today. This is my first performance of my tenure this year for 2019, so forgive me if I'm a little dusty. I blame all the refurbishments.
Too soon?
Got it. But I'm so happy to be here every year and to get to come to Orlando and enjoy this great, warm, sunny weather. It really does make it special. I actually like the cold weather for this particular evening because it allows everyone to cuddle together and to experience this as a one big family. So with that, I should get on because you all have fast passes to attend to. So yes, cuddle up, take a breath, enjoy these amazing performers and these spectacular songs done in a way that no one can top. Let's begin. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin who was betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus." Caesar Augustus, that all the world should be registered. And all went, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for him in the inn. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord."
Yeah.
And suddenly there was, with the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill towards men." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king. Behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose in the east and have come to worship him." And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. They saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you.
The story of the birth of Christ has been told and retold for over 2,000 years. About 200 years ago, in a small church in Austria, the organist, Franz, came to Joseph Moore and said, "Father Joseph, the organ is broken and we will have no music for the Christmas Eve service." Later in the day, as Joseph made his rounds, he visited a home where a baby had just been born, and he thought about the birth of the baby Jesus. And he was so inspired that he wrote a poem, and he went back to the church, and he found Franz. He said, "If we can't have the old organ, maybe we can have a new song, and you can play the guitar." And Franz said, "Father, I only know three chords." "Then make a song with three chords." So Franz hummed and strummed, and soon he had composed the most beautiful and beloved of all the Christmas carols. Gift bestowed upon us all during this special time of year. Tonight, people around the world mark this joyful season with heartfelt sentiment. As we each treasure our unique holiday traditions of family, faith, and culture, let us join together in celebrating the birth of the blessed babe in the manger and rejoice in the universal message of peace on earth and goodwill toward men. Joy to the world.
Thank you.
is born. Unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Start the holiday season. Wow. I am just always so impressed to hear that cacophony of sound in such glorious harmony by so many talented people, helmed by you, Maestro. It's really something else to watch. I'm so glad you all were here. Enjoy the rest of your night at Epcot or wherever it even takes you. And most importantly, peace on earth. Good night.